On the Medical Watch tonight, an unlikely route to the brain.
WGN medical reporter Dina Baer has more on a new but narrow approach to repairing brain abnormalities.
Two.
This is a new way to save lives after a stroke or if someone has an aneurysm. It's a route cardiac surgeons take to fix arteries and valves in the heart. Now neurosurgeons are following and picking up improved safety and quicker recovery rates along the way.
So it was an incidental finding. Back in January, I was having a really weird headache I've never experienced before. And I just told my husband, like, something just doesn't seem right.
Christy Tormey was shocked to learn she needed surgery to fix two aneurysms, one behind each eye.
I was terrified.
The 33-year-old mother of five was even more surprised when her doctor told her he'd be going through her wrist to reach her brain.
I trusted him. When I went in and he told me, you know, this is what we're going to do, my life was basically in his hands.
But it was Christy's hand where the aneurysm repair began. The procedure starts by threading a thinly designed catheter into the radial artery, then slowly navigating the wire up the arm, making a turn at the shoulder, then another straight up to the brain. Dr. Stefan Munich says he adopted the technique about 2 years ago.
What we have found is that turn is not as problematic as we had initially thought, and we're able to access, again, most blood vessels and perform most procedures through this approach.
In Christy's case, once the catheter reached each target, Dr. Munich deployed a device to redirect blood flow away from the weakened wall of the aneurysm, essentially preventing the vessels from rupturing.
We can treat everything from strokes to aneurysms to vascular malformations through a transradial approach.
Now the Rush neurosurgeon is performing the majority of his procedures through the wrist versus the more traditional route through the femoral artery in the groin.
The femoral artery is a deeper artery. There was a complication rate of accessing that artery of about 5 to 7%. When we access the radial artery, that complication rate drops to about 1 to 3%.
And recovery time is decreased for patients. They just wear this bracelet to apply pressure to the access point to stop postoperative bleeding.
I was moving around, I was talking, I was eating. I actually wanted to get out of bed and walk around the hospital floor. The recovery is amazing. I feel great. It's like I've never even had the surgeries.
The approach may not work for every patient. If there's an unexpected obstacle, doctors switch to the more conventional route through the femoral artery, which requires patients to lie flat for hours after the procedure. Back to you.